All the talk today is about, are we going to see inflation or deflation? And before we do that, I think it's really important to get a microeconomic level understanding of why do prices increase or decrease. And so we'll do a little example of me starting a business and when do the prices increase or decrease in that market. So let's say I wanted to start a cupcake factory. Cupcake factory. And then actually in the process of this video, even though this isn't the intent of this playlist, the intent of this playlist is eventually for you to be able to go to your econ professor and say, no, we won't or we will have inflation or deflation for reasons X, Y, and Z. But in the process, you might learn a little bit about accounting and starting a cupcake factory. So let's say I want to start a cupcake factory. It costs $1 million to build. So $1 million to build. And just the economics of the factory is it costs $500,000 a year to operate. So that's literally to pay the electric bills, to have people sitting there ready to make cupcakes. And I have accountants and all the rest. I have to pay people to clean the place. And let's say the economics of the cupcakes themselves, the cost per cupcake, so is $1 cost. Let me do that in red because actually, I'll do all of these in red because these are, well, I'll do that later. So the cost per cupcake is $1. $1 cost per cupcake. And where does that cost? Well, that's, some of it is the incremental labor. Let's assume that I had a completely automated, robotic factory. So there's actually, let's say there's very little labor at my factory. And this is just the cost of ingredients, cream and sugar and butter and, those little wax paper things that the cupcake is held in and the electricity to run my robots and then, over time to kind of maintain the robots that make my factory. And so what would be the economic, let's say I think that the general, that I can charge $2 per cupcake. $2 per cupcake. So just as an exercise, let's think about, and one other thing. My $1 million factory can produce 1 million cupcakes. 1 million cupcakes per year. So just as a couple of exercises, because I'm a businessman, I'm not just going to plunk down $1 million before I figure out how much money I can make. Let's think about how much money we can make in different scenarios. So let's call this scenario one, which is kind of the best scenario. So we'll call this the optimist, is that I sell 1 million cupcakes. So my factory can produce 1 million cupcakes, and I sell 1 million cupcakes. If I sell 1 million cupcakes, and I'll take a side here because this is an issue that I want to bring up a lot. I am fully utilized. My factory can produce 1 million cupcakes, and I, in this scenario, I'm producing 1 million cupcakes. So we would say we're 100% utilized. How much are you producing relative to what you can produce? 100%. So if I sell 1 million cupcakes, what would be my revenue? And I won't go into the details of accounting. Let me make revenue in green because that's a good thing. So what is my revenue? If my background weren't already black, I would make that in black. And that's why people say being in the black or being in the red. Because being in the black means you're positive, and being in the red means you're negative. But my background is black, so I'll use green. So we'll say being in the green. So what would be my revenue? Well, I'm selling 1 million cupcakes. And this is my optimistic scenario. And let's say I actually am able to charge $2 per cupcake. And we'll have obviously, the whole discussion is what happens to this price over a bunch of different scenarios. So I am able to charge $2 per cupcake. So my revenue is equal to $2 million per year. Right? I produce 1 million. This is 1 million cupcakes per year. What are my cost of goods? Cost of goods. And I'll write the common acronym there, COGS. And this is what you'll see. If you actually look at income statements for companies, public companies, you will see something like cost of goods or variable cost, but usually actually cost of goods or cost of services is what you'll see most often. And so if I have 1 million cupcakes, let me do this in red. I said I would do it in red. So I have 1 million cupcakes times, what's my cost per cupcake? Times $1 cost per cupcake. So it's $1 million per year. And so what is my profit just from selling the cupcakes, before I think about how much does it cost for me to, you know, all of the overhead expenses, just kind of the money I'm just getting from selling the cupcakes, and that term is called gross profit. Gross profit. And that's essentially how much am I bringing in from the cupcakes, and then how much are just those cupcakes costing me? So I'll do a line here. I'll subtract that from that. So gross profit, I am making $1 million, 2 minus 1. And you might say, oh, that's great. I'm making a million. You're making $1 million on your cupcake factory in this scenario. I was like, oh, no, we're not done yet. This is just the gross profit. This is just the money directly from the cupcakes. But I have all of this overhead expense. And oftentimes, on a regular income statement, it'll be called selling general and administrative, or overhead costs, or operating costs, or something like that. I'll just call it overhead. I'll make it red because it's an expense. So this should be red too, COGS. And so I'll call it overhead. Once again, that's kind of the offices and the accountants and the bookkeepers. So that's going to be $500,000 a year. And then how much am I making from the business now? From the business. And this is called operating profit. Operating profit. How much am I making from operating the business? And I won't go into all of the details of an income statement, but any income statement you look at will have this operating profit line. And everything below the operating profit line, just as an aside, will kind of cover things not related to the actual operations of the business. It'll, you know, it'll be expenses related to financing the business, if I took a loan for that $1 million, or it'll be expenses related to taxes and all of that. But we're just assuming a world, an ideal world, that doesn't have taxes. And let's say, assume, you know, I inherited this $1 million, so I didn't finance it. So my operating profit is really my profit, because I don't have to pay taxes on it. So let's see. I got gross profit just from selling the cupcakes, $1 million. Overhead, the accountants and the people cleaning the factory and et cetera, that's $500,000 a year. So my operating profit is $500,000. And that's pretty good. I mean, I had a $1 million investment, one-time investment, and I'm assuming that this $500,000 to year to operate it also maintains my building. So this kind of $1 million investment will exist forever. Right, and I'm making $500,000 a year in this scenario. So that's a 50% return, right? Which is great. If I told you I had an investment where I could make 50% a year on your money, you'd say, oh yeah, here's my money, here's a check. But this is, of course, an optimistic scenario. Let's think of other scenarios. And there's actually a ton of scenarios, because you can keep adjusting how much you sell and the price you sell it for and come up with different numbers here. And it's actually a fun exercise to do in Excel, and you can do probability distributions and all that, but I won't worry about that right now. Let's do a pessimistic. Well, actually, let's do the scenario of what do I have to do just to make sure that I don't lose money, right? So to make sure I don't lose money, let's kind of do it backwards. So we're going to do a break-even analysis. And trust me, this will eventually lead to whether we are going to see inflation or deflation in this economy. And I think in the meantime, you might learn a little interesting things about starting a business. But so let's say I just want to know what has to happen for my operating profit to be zero, right? To not be negative. What's the minimum number of cupcakes I need to make, or what price I have to charge? So if my operating profit is zero, we know my overhead, this is fixed. This is a fixed expense. There's nothing I can do about it. Just if you want to have a cupcake factory, it will cost you $500,000. And I'll write it as a negative number, because we're going to subtract it from the gross profit. So what does the gross profit have to be? So the gross profit, in order for this to come out to be zero, the gross profit has to be $500,000. And so now we can think of a bunch of scenarios where we end up with $500,000 gross profit. We could, if we sold, what did we say? If we sold a, so how can we get to $500,000? Let's say we're selling, I don't know, instead of selling 1 million cupcakes, we're only selling 500,000 cupcakes. 500,000 cupcakes, right, this should work out. So then our revenue will be 500K. And let's say I'm still selling it for $2 a cupcake, times $2. And so that would be $1 million of revenue coming into the door per year. And then my cost of cupcakes, or my cost of goods sold, is what I should be doing this in red. I'm not being consistent. My cost of goods sold is what? We said it was a dollar per cupcake, right? So it's 500,000 times $1. And really, just so you know, I mean, it would be silly to ever sell a cupcake for less than a dollar, right? Then, I mean, you're just kind of handing checks out to your cupcake eaters. But anyway, in this case, my cost of goods sold would be minus 500,000, and everything would work out. So this is a break-even scenario where I sell 500,000 cupcakes at $2 per cupcake, with this being the cost of goods, and then I'll make 500,000 gross profit, and then take out the overhead, and at least I won't make a loss. But this is interesting, because this tells me if I'm charging $2 per cupcake, I have to sell at least 500,000 cupcakes to make money. So you might say, well, yeah, so it would never be rational to sell anything less than 500,000 cupcakes, otherwise you shouldn't operate the business. And what we'll do in future videos is we'll actually explore situations in which that does happen, and in which people will start to kind of cut prices to actually compete, and in the process they'll be doing very irrational things. But anyway, I realize I've run out of time in this video. I'll see you in the next one, and we'll actually see what happens once I start my cupcake factory.